Hi, this is Songyan again. Welcome to my learned spoken Japanese lesson number 41. Till lesson 39, I focused on nouns, verbs, adjectives, particles, etc., the talk of states and actions. In this lesson, I changed gears and from now on, I hope to cover some narrower subject a little deeper. In this lesson, I will talk about food. This lesson will be over the next 3 videos. One of the basic needs for which we learn a foreign language is to be able to visit that foreign country and survive with a degree of comfort. Being able to describe the food of our choice and get it is very fundamental to our survival. I hope to give you some vocabulary for this. When I was on business travel to one company for a long stay, we used to get hosted by the host organization practically every day. When going out for dinner or lunch with someone else, we also need to follow the common courtesies used in those countries. We have seen some phrases related to this already. We will cover a few more. There were also some visits when I was visiting a large number of organizations for very short meetings where I did not have the benefit of a host helping me to choose a restaurant or food. So I will describe some types of food joints and types of food. My difficulties got compounded as I am a vegetarian. At times I simply survived on fruits, milkshakes, fruit juices and ice creams. These were very nice. However, I do not wish you suffer in a similar manner and hence I would like to equip you with a better vocabulary. This lesson will not describe any food in detail. It just provides vocabulary. The next lesson will be more about the task of asking for specific food and generally conversing in a restaurant. First, let us consider the type of food joints. Kissaten is a coffee shop. You can have coffee and snacks here. Most often, the coffee shop at the hotel is where you will be having your breakfast. Restaurant is a restaurant. This is a transliterated word. There will be plenty of eateries in Japan. Every other outlet in a shopping area would be a kissaten or a restaurant. Ryori means type of food. It's a cuisine. I found no difficulty in locating Indian restaurants. There were many. In longer stays, these helped me to keep in touch with my native food. Needless to say, you can have Japanese, French or Italian food as well. Shojin Ryori is supposed to be Buddhist and serve purely vegetarian fare. I have not tried them. Nomiya may not fit this category fully. It's a bar. Let us now get to know the types of food. Kudamono are fruits. Yasai mono are vegetables. Nomi mono are beverages. Niku is meat. Sakana is fish. Tori is generally bird but normally chicken. Shokuji is a general word for meal or food. Asagohan is breakfast. Hirugohan is lunch. Bangohan is dinner. You already know asa, hiru and ban for the time of the day, namely morning, noon and evening. Gohan is supposed to be cooked rice, but in this context, they refer to the meal of the time. Let us see the sentences we have here and relate them to the appropriate lessons. Hoshi is a word for expressing desire. We saw this in the lesson number 39. So, nomimono ga hoshi means I need a drink. Nomimono is any beverage, basically liquid food that can be drunk. Noda ga kawaite imasu. Noda is throat. Kawaite imasu is present continuous sentence. Kawaku is a group one verb meaning to get dry. My throat is getting dry, which means I am thirsty. O nomimono wa. This is an unfinished question. It does not end in ka. Wa is the topic indicator. So, the waiter or host is introducing a topic and waiting for your response. Thus, it is equivalent to asking, how about a beverage? Wo nomimono. The O prefix is for respectful reference as we discussed in earlier lessons. The Japanese are fond of beer. If you do not have enough stock of beer, do not invite a Japanese person to your home for a drink. Biru wo onegai shimasu. Onegai means a request. It is a compelling phrase which the person addressed would not ignore. Once in a busy railway station, I needed directions. I stopped a person who was rushing to catch a train with the phrase, Chotto onegai shimasu. He stopped like a high-speed vehicle to which someone had applied the brake. Such is the power of this word. After helping me, he ran. Such nice people, such nice culture. God bless them. Negau is a group one verb meaning to ask or to request. One negai has the prefix o again. Omizu wo kudasai. Mizu is drinking water. Omizu has a honorific wo prefix to mizu. Water is essential for life, so we respect it. This is the popular please give me form, that is the kudasai form. Substitute mizu for any other item as appropriate. Please give me water is the meaning of this sentence. Japanese voters had a notice suggesting drink from the tap. The tap water in the bathroom is supposed to be good enough in its purity for drinking. Orange juice wa arimasu ka? A very simple sentence. Do you have orange juice? You can use this structure to ask for the availability of any item. Are we sure it is not some honorable juice called Renji juice with a O prefix? Believe me, it is not. Orange is orange. Now, let's get some vocabulary focused on beverages and related items. Half of these words are transliterations. Japan is a Kohi country. Kohi is coffee. You can find Starbucks all over. Brakku Kohi is black coffee. Brakku is simply the transliteration of black. Ocha is Japanese tea. It is served in a cup without handles. It will have no milk or sugar. It's like green tea. Kocha is the Indian type of tea, brown in color with milk and sugar. Aisu is ice and chi is tea. Aisu chi is a transliteration of iced tea. Gyunyo is milk. The transliterated form miruku is also widely used. Atatakai means warm. Atatakai miruku is simply warm or hot milk. Cocoa is hot chocolate. Visa mizu means drinking water just a short while ago. Jusu is juice. Biru for beer has been used widely all through this tutorial. Wine is wine. Whiskey is whiskey. Sake is a traditional Japanese drink. It is actually rice wine. Sake is also referred to as osake with a honorific o prefix to sake. Sato is sugar. Kori is ice. Sato and kori by themselves are not beverages. They go with the other beverages, hence they have been included in the slide. Kudamono are fruits. Ringo is apple. Ichigo is strawberry. Nashi is the Japanese pear. Mikan is mandarin orange. Budo is a seedless variety of grapes. Banana, melon, orangey, pineapple and gurepu fruits are all transliterations. The juice of these fruits are expressed with the name of the fruit followed by the word jusu. Thus, jusu, orange jusu, tomato jusu are all transliterations. Here are the terms related to an international breakfast. Except for two items here, the rest are all transliterations. If you have gone through my lessons on transliterations and how they come out, you will have no difficulty in understanding these. I will just run through these for you. Konfureku is cornflakes. Otomiru is oatmeal. Skuramburu egg is scrambled egg. The next two are the Japanese words. Medamayaki is fried eggs. Hanjuku no tomago is half-boiled egg, tomago being egg. Omuretsu is omelette. Bacon is bacon. Hamu is ham. Sausage is sausage. Hotokeki is pancake. Bafuru is baffle. French toasto is French toast. Rorupan is rolls. Kurovasan is croissant. Muffin is English muffins. Donatsu is donuts. Jamu is jam. Marmaledu is marmalade. By now, you must be gaining confidence. As far as food is concerned, all transliterated words from English seem to be acceptable in Japan. That's a great relief. That brings us to the end of lesson number 41. This subject will be continued in lesson 42 as well. Please view the text. To watch the entire series, go to my channel, I will read it. Gambatte. Deva. Mata.